Devin Witherspoon, to me, I like him a lot, bro.
He's the guy.
I like him a lot. I'm trying to not like him so much, but I like him a lot. 6'1", 180.
Wait, no, he had Witherspoon.
He has him at 6 foot. On the Illini's website, they have him at 6'1".
Oh, it was 14 to New England. That's where Kiper had him. So 3 picks ahead of us.
Yeah, so with him, man, this season, 12 games, he had 3 picks, 17 PBUs. But, yeah, when we talk Devin, excellent change of direction and technique. When you watch him impress man-to-man, this dude is, it looked like clinic tape at times, man, in the sense of, like, how he's able to stay square, how he's able to mirror these guys. And then when you talk his ball skills, he gets his head around. Like, it's unreal. And he goes, he's attacking that ball. If the ball's in his area, it looks like it's his. That's how he plays it. And we said that PZ Jr. is a willing tackler. This dude right here, bro, he's trying to knock your head off, but in a fundamental way. That's the part that makes him.
So this dude's like J.C. Horn.
Yes. Like, when you talk about a physical tackler, he will co- man, I'm watching this dude fire off on the running back from Michigan. I'm like, bro. And I'm talking like fundamental, not on some reckless. Cause we talk, I don't want a big hitter. I don't like big hitters. Big hitters don't tackle you. They just hit you, make a sound, and these guys at this level just stay up and keep running. I don't want that. He's not that. He's a tackler, but a physical tackler, bro. You watch this dude, man, he will light it up, man. So I definitely like that. And I also think, you know, watching him and how they used him at Illinois, he can play inside or outside in terms of if you need to bump him in the slot. Think how you did with Cam Sutton at times. He has that in his wheelhouse as well, but he has more size and just I think he's just a better player on the outside. Like, you can play him in the slot, but I think you minimize him. Because he's like that on the outside. And when you talk about his confidence, ton of confidence, ultra competitive, very similar to PZ. All three of these dudes we're going to talk about got that, like, ultra competitive alpha male. Like, they are the big dogs on their secondaries, which I like, especially at corner. But then I also think that when you talk about his quicks, like, because of, once again, him being a little bit shorter. And I'll see if he really 6'1". He looks really, like, he looks a little bit shorter to me than how PZ is. But not just on no inch type thing, you know? But I do feel like, man, that's what makes his change of direction so much better, because his technique, like, he's lower. When you bend a little bit, you know, you keep that center gravity low, it's a lot easier to go left and right. Whereas for PZ, he's just a little bit taller. And it slows him there, but that's why he doesn't give, in terms of Devin, he doesn't give as much separation early on, and it just hasn't been good position. Now, in terms of the knocks or the questions I have on him, I just want to see what the 40 time is. He plays crazy fast. I love his quicks. I just want to know, do you have that real, real long speed, or is the quicks just tricking me to thinking you got that? I got to wait for that. I'm also concerned at times with bigger body receivers. How are you going to handle those guys on the outside? Because to me, he is the shorter of the three between Joey Porter Jr. and Christian Gonzalez. He's the shorter one. I'm just looking like, man, we know some of these dudes can go up. I think of a George Pickens when he goes up top. Can you match
that? For us, it's all Jamar Chase. Yeah. That's all we're thinking about right now.
It's like, can you match that? That's the only thing that makes me a little nervous. And then I also feel like he's just one of those guys that I do like him as a true man-to-man corner. I don't want to play him off. I think he can do it, but I think you're minimizing him if you do that. I would love for him to be one of them dudes you just say, hey, that's your side. You lock that up. Kind of like when you watch the Jets and how they use Sauce Gardner. Like, I would love that for him. And then the last thing that I do got to complain about with him. Now, he's a physical tackler. He will hit you, and he's very fundamentally sound with it. But, son, these angles, bro, he got to improve, bro. When it's run support, sometimes, man, you be looking like, hey, man, open your eyes, bro. What you looking at, man? And that just concerns me. And
that's some simple shit. That's literally just coaching.
It's like, bro, come on, man. What are you looking at? Why are you doing that? Don't do that. You messing it up right now. Everything else I love, but, and when you get there, it's beautiful. But sometimes I'm just like, yo, what you looking at? Like, seriously, that, because we in a division where you got to stop that run, and they like to make your corners tackle. That's the only thing. But other than that, yeah, I love him. He fire.
If he runs that 40 time good, though, you think he creeps up into the top 10?
Potentially, yeah. If he get you 4.3 anything, yeah, he gone. Yeah.
See, I think we have different attitudes on this. If that's the case, I would just rather him run some shitty time. Because remember, I was saying this last year, like, even with Devin Lloyd, I'm like, good thing he ran a 4.66.
Because he gets the chance, yeah.
What I'm seeing in these games is he just plays faster than that. And I feel the same way about Jordan Addison. Pickett's talking about, oh, he could run a 4.29, a 4.3, or whatever.
Yeah.
It's like, no, don't do that, because if you do it, you're going to go too high for us. Yeah. I'd rather you run something bad, because I know what you can do on the football field.
Mm-hmm.
So it's this weird dynamic where you're probably wanting, you just want confirmation.
I want the confirmation, yeah. Because I hate that feeling of, man, you look like you're playing fast, and then you throw a 4.5, and I'm like, bro, how is this the same corner? Like,
when
Joe Hayden ran that 4.5, I was hurt.
I want people to drop.
When Joe Hayden ran a 4.5, we was all hurt. Like, bro, there's no way that guy ran a 4.5. It's no way.
Claypool duped us.
It is with okie doke.
That's the dangers of the 40.
It is. The 40. Hey, man, the 40 will make you
pass up
your
on.
Life.
You'll pass up on people that you.
The 40
you're like,
would
man,
change your life.
This guy plays way faster than this.
Tyquan Thornton went first round behind that 40. Think about that last year. New England.
No, he went second.
Second,
yeah,
excuse
yeah.
me, to New England.
He
yeah.
went way higher than
way
what his projections
higher,
were. Some people had him going undrafted.
Yeah, people still bring up the Hay Bay situation where he went because of what he ran.
That was just the Raiders.
But the speed part, though, speed is what does it, man. It's hard to just not believe speed because you're like, yo, I could coach the rest of it. I could figure it out. At least you tell yourself that.
Mm-hmm, Thornton actually played kind of good this year, huh?
He did. Yeah, he was straight.
He looked good at Baylor, too. Yeah. I was wondering why they had him as a 6th or 7th round pick, or maybe even on draft, because he was smooth. He had good body control and everything.
I thought he was smooth as well. I just didn't think he was a refined route runner. I thought he was a one-trick pony in the sense of vertical routes or stop routes. Kind of like when we talked about the dude from Miami. Was it Rambo?
Yeah.
It was just like, yo, they're fast, but it's either vertical or stops. And at this level, it's like, you got to be able to run routes. And because he was super thin, we didn't know if he could beat. Like, all right, if you're going to be a one-trick pony, are you just going to be another Ted Ginn, essentially, because you're so wiry as well? But now, he was definitely all right, though.